I'm a cheetah, run up down the air in the scene. Not to just like Vegeta Prince, and I'm an heir to the sea. I mean, for real. Test the driver's saw, so I don't even grab the wheel. That's a lot on my chest, but it don't mean a man is stealing. Man, I'm walking with some money, man, I mean a couple mil. Ew, think you need a mail. You ain't even eating while I'm feasting in the field. That's why I'm always cheesing, cause I feel like Uncle Phil. And all these losers think the fresh, but they ain't half the man as well. Are you irresponsible without your money or not? Thought he had a plan, but we gon' foil his plot. Heard him sneaking in, so we just ran in the spot. And then we spin the block around just like the hell on the clock. Are you irresponsible without your money or not? Thought he had a plan, but we gon' foil his plot. Heard him sneaking in, so we just ran in the spot. And then we spin the block around just like the hands on the clock.
Just like the hands on the clock, I go back to bat when I'm doing numbers. All the mad that I'm driving the bus, so they threw me under. Heard they mad, they don't wanna bust, so they boo each other. Think that they're the winning team, go losing, then they choose another. And that's okay, cause I'm competing with me, not you. I live with blessings like I can't stop sneezing, not you.
EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to the Sunshine State in TIAA Bank Field here in Jacksonville. This crowd excited to see their Jaguars as both teams emerged from their tunnels a moment ago. We are just about ready for football as the Jags get set to match up with the Indianapolis Colts.
Josh Lambeau to kick off for Jacksonville.
Time for a much-needed and much-welcome diversion. The NFL is back. Here we go, week one. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. And from the 25, they worked this to the 29, a gain of four.
C.J. Henderson.
At the end of all that hitting and hollering, it was a four-yard run, so the offense is going to go back down and feel pretty good about themselves. Defensively, you have to feel okay because you didn't let it turn into a bigger run, but the goal, shut it down for 2 yards or less. That's when you start to feel good about yourselves.
Marlon Mack, the ball carrier.
Good pickup there by Marlon Mack, and he was a 1,000-yard runner in 2019 and has been very consistent in moving the ball for the Colts. Last two seasons, at least 8 touchdowns rushing each year.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. Throwing, Rivers, sliding out of the pocket. And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down. Rivers incomplete on first down. Here's second and 10. To throw again. Rivers. He'll find Paris Campbell. That's complete. They get 6. That'll leave them with 3rd and 4.
It's a gain of 6. And it's 3rd down.
This is Wilkins. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. That good for 19 and a first down. So in Jacksonville territory now. Here's a 1st and 10 at the 39-yard line. And they're able to get this one past the 30 to the 25-yard line. Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another first down. So back-to-back big runs, picking apart this defense on the opening drive.
I thought this was a passing league. I thought this was the era we were in where the ball was always in the air, right?
They didn't get the memo.
They didn't get the memo, and I know this to be true. Offensive linemen still, to this day, they want to run the football. They want to fire out and hit people across the line of scrimmage, and they're clearing space.
A gain of 6 there on first. 6 yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's 2nd and 4. This will be caught just inside the 10. And all the way down inside the 5 to the 4. It's a really nice 15-yard pickup, and now it's 1st and goal. They'll run here with Taylor. And he takes it in for a Colts score. Jonathan Taylor with his first career touchdown in his first career game. And the Colts take it right down and score on the opening drive. And this is good to make it 7-0 Indy.
Makes the score Colts 7, Jaguars nothing. Tucker McCann set to kick off.
McCann's got it teed up. Right after the touchdown to extend their lead, now maybe opening the door a little bit there by allowing starting field position at the 40. Minshew going to lead up the Jaguars first and 10 at their own 42. Here's a give to Miller. The All-Pro Justin Houston in on the tackle.
They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here, and if it's a long play, so be it. But the main goal, get a couple of first downs, run some plays, run some clock, allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath, settle down, and relax a little bit after they just gave up a score.
And he's able to get this one down to the 40-yard line. 15 yards on the play, first down.
First and 10 at the 40-yard line.
Minshew, first and 10. Hit as he throws there, incomplete.
Pressure, and that's certainly going to be a key to this game going forward. And that time, they were able to get in there and influence the throw. And remember, quarterbacks got to get rid of it. They don't have the tucker roll that they can fall back on anymore.
So second down and 10. Once again, they'll go from the 40. Now a toss right to Miller. Finally be taken down, but not before he gets it to the Colts 8. He's able to rip off 32 on that one. It's a first down. He had his eyes on the end zone once he hit the secondary, but they're finally able to slow him down.
Yeah, and I've got to look at this one from the defensive point of view. You just mentioned finally able to slow him down. They've got to figure out a way to make that at the point of attack, at the line of scrimmage, because once he gets through, he's shredding them.
And that ball is caught by DJ Chark for the Jags touchdown. 8 yards on the touchdown pass. Jaguars are within an extra point of tying this one up. He was on point throwing the ball right there. He had the big play to get him down close, and then he delivers a touchdown pass on first and goal.
And you mentioned the big play that got them down close. I think that big play left them reeling a little bit. They didn't recover from it. And you know, they always talk about having to have a short memory on defense after a big play against you. Looks like their memory was a little too long there.
And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. The Colts come to the line ready to start their next drive. They were successful last time finding the end zone on their opening drive of the season. And they get another shot here with a first and 10. From the shotgun, it's Rivers going up top. And that's caught inside the 30.
That's all you got?
Touchdown, Indianapolis.
To number 89.
A big play there. His first NFL reception goes for 6. And the Colts have taken the lead. The PAT up and good, but hold on a second. There is a flag. Well, we looked at each other right away. We knew that flag was coming out.
And I always enjoy the conversation post because officials always tell you, I don't want to throw the flag, but you caused the play. You did it. I had to.
That'll be taken about a yard deep. And in hindsight, probably should have taken a knee as he only gets this out to the 16-yard line.
Their own 16-yard line.
So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. Off play action, it's Minshew. And he'll let this one go deep for Chark. And that will be incomplete. Would have been a big hitter if they had connected. Instead, it's second down.
That's what you're going to need to do against those big receivers. You got to get in there and get physical with them. That time he got in close, got in tight, and knocked the ball away.
Flushed out right. Looking for Chark again. This time he's got him. And he almost gets this to the 30, taken down about a yard shy. A gain of 13. It's a first down.
First and 10 at the 29-yard line.
Throwing on first down is Minshew. Escaping the pressure right. That one complete. He finds Chark. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another first down.
Nice play by DJ Chark there, and he's a great example of how a guy can improve from his rookie year to season 2. Quiet as a rookie, a 1,000-yard season last year, ended up becoming a Pro Bowl selection for the Jaguars.
A A first down carry now for Miller. Looking for a crease, can't find one. Stopped at the line of scrimmage.
He was brought down.
Now another timeout called for by the offense. And that's their second charge timeout here in this first quarter. They're down to one remaining. From the gun, Minshew to throw. Flush to his right. Now on the run, he'll throw it back deep over the middle. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
I think that interception happened for two reasons. Quarterback gets outside the pocket and panics a little bit. And receiver doesn't make sure he's absolutely in an open spot. There's a guy lurking, took the ball from
him. Yeah, so don't wave your arms, right, as a receiver if you're not wide open.
Got to know that you're open. Otherwise, just don't do it.
Touchdown, Indianapolis. Paris Campbell, 94 yards. And the Colts strike quickly here for 6 points.
Well, Brandon, if we go back to our meeting with the offensive coordinator, he showed us his script. Didn't show us everything now. He said, here's the script for the game. I think everything's going according to plan in a big way. 3 drives, 3 touchdowns.
Yeah, that's about as good as, that is as good as you can do, I guess. So, well done.
Yeah, well done indeed. Tremendous execution.
And he'll just take a seat, and the drive will begin at the 25-yard line.
Their own 25-yard line.
This will probably be the last play of the quarter. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. He's going to try and go deep again. And some space here. And a big gain that time. He's out of bounds on what will be the final play of this first quarter.
You call it, we all it, baby.
A pretty wild first quarter. 21-7, our score.
21, Jaguars 7.
So first and 10 now from the 30. A throw left side to start out. That's complete. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. It'll be a gain of 10 to start the drive out by a few inches. That'll be a first down. So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. Now a throw to the end zone on first down, but it winds up incomplete. T.Y. Hilton, the intended receiver. And now it's second down.
He was covered by C.J. Henderson.
Throwing again. Rivers. Dumps this one off to Mack. And he will be brought down at about the 6-yard line. A 14-yard gain there as they look to improve this 14-point lead.
This offense continues to be a hot knife through butter. 3 drives, 3 scores, and knocking on the door again on drive number 4.
And not able to break away this time as they're going to stop it right around the line of scrimmage. They come up here with another shot from the 6-yard line, and it's 2nd and goal now.
At the 6-yard line.
Here's Taylor. And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Indianapolis. Jonathan Taylor making quite a splash with his 2nd touchdown in his NFL debut. And the Colts add on to their lead.
It is good.
Point after, right down the middle. And the lead now to 3 touchdowns at 21. McCann's got it teed up. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback.
Their own 25-yard line.
The Jacksonville offense set to begin their next drive. And last time wasn't pretty. One play and an interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see if they want to go ahead and throw the ball again now on this drive after what happened on the last one. Throw it on the first play. Give the quarterback some confidence.
See what happens. Give him 10 yards there, and about by the nose of the football, he's going to have a first down.
35-yard line.
to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. And they'll run with a man signed away from Washington. It's Chris Thompson.
The ball carried.
And that time, the tackle by Malik Hooker.
He's brought down at the 37-yard line.
Typically, we think it's the strong safeties that are better tacklers, especially closer to the line of scrimmage amidst traffic. But in this case, how about the free safety coming up and making the big-time play?
Minshew going to be intercepted for the third time. Picked off near the 32. And they're going to set up shop at the 32-yard line.
First and 10.
So that is three interceptions now in this first half. And you hate to ask the question, but let's be honest. We're thinking about it. Do you need to go in a different direction next series?
Potentially. We know that he's probably not going to be on the Pro Bowl ballot. That's not really his stature here. But he has been their starting quarterback for this game. So they've got to weigh things about who's behind him. Do they think he can snap it back into gear? Maybe change up the play calling to help.
He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked by Jared Wilson. And he'll take this all the way down inside the 40. Well, look, we're watching a quarterback here that's obviously been around for a long time. That's a throw he wishes he had back.
He certainly does, but as you well know, this is a guy that's used to taking a few chances, used to fitting it into tight windows. These are throws that he's made before. Didn't happen.
And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked up by Kenny Moore. I know it appeared he was saying, hey, give me the football, I'm open, but I don't know if that's a pass that he should have thrown there.
Well, I don't think we've ever met a wide receiver that doesn't think he is open or is about to be open.
True.
So when you throw your hand up in the air and tell your quarterback, hey, I'm available, he's trusting that you are. In this case, he was not, and it turned into disaster for them.
Second and a yard at their 49-yard line.
Now it's a bootleg with Rivers. It's complete here to T.Y. Hilton. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. The catch and run going to wind up netting him 33 yards. So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. That's complete to Jonathan Taylor out of the backfield.
And he takes this one in for a Colts touchdown.
Jonathan
Phillip Rivers with his third touchdown pass of the game. And the Colts are able to grow their lead.
Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. Off the option, that's complete. And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Indianapolis. Paris Campbell, already his second touchdown here in this opening weekend. And the Colts, they add on to their advantage. The PAT would extend their lead, but there is a flag on the play. So they will accept the penalty and move forward. After the roughing penalty on the PAT, they'll kick off from 15 yards further upfield. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback.
25-yard line.
Coming out with a jumbo package to start the drive. The Jaguars now will use the last of their timeouts. And with that, they're now out of timeouts and still plenty of time remaining here in this second quarter. Minshew and the Jags now with a first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. Off the play fake, he'll set up to throw it. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down. I hate to sound really negative, but at this point, an incomplete pass, almost a moral victory that it's not picked off.
Well, you may hate to sound negative, but that was negative.
It was very negative, I know. But all these first half interceptions, it's been tough to watch.
Yeah, couldn't find a silver lining in this one. Much more like lead.
They do get a couple, but they'll be left staring at a third and eight coming up.
Makes it third and eight.
And we've hit the two-minute mark in this first half of action. remind you that coming up in 2 minutes, we'll again head down to visit with Jonathan Coachman in Orlando, back for another year. He'll have scores from around the NFL here on this opening weekend. And oh, they almost had another one. They are all over the football in this game. Nearly another pick. Now fourth down.
It's now fourth down.
Already down two scores. They're going to go for this rather than settle for three. They're going to try and throw. Able to complete this to Chenault. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. A big pickup of 12 yards on fourth down to keep this drive from stalling. And hard running's going to get him over the 40 to the 42. Give him 4 yards there on the first down keeper.
Well, if you're going to run the read option, typically, you've got to keep an eye on the defensive end.
And what does that mean? What are you looking for with a defensive end?
Well, you want to play off of what he does. If he collapses inside towards the running back, then you pull it and take it yourself outside in. If he stays outside, you go ahead and leave it with the running back. In this case, pulled it and got good yardage himself.
49-yard line.
Connection made with Chenault. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. A big one there for the Jags. 18 yards, first down.
First and 10 at the 32.
Partner, this is one of the best routes anyone can have in their offensive playbook. Tough to defend because you think it's a go route, and then he breaks it back on the comeback. But there's one other thing you need as well.
A well-thrown ball.
Exactly right. Gavin Guy has some precision in throwing the football because of the timing of the route.
And nearly another interception. They've been around the ball all game.
It's second down and 10.
Here's second and 10 now from about the 32. Out of the gun is Minshew. That's incomplete. Nearly another pick. My goodness.
Intended for DJ Chark. Incomplete. Brings up third down and 10.
This offense was on the move. Now two straight incompletions have them looking at third and 10. They'll throw now on the final play. And now here is another interception. Picked off by Kenny Moore. And he will be brought down as time has now run out on this first half of action. So we've reached halftime here on opening weekend. As we send you a couple hours south of here to Orlando, that's where we check in with a coach and our EA Sports halftime report. McCann's got it teed up. This will make it into the end zone. And he'll just sit on this one as their drive will start at the 25. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And the interception last time on the opponent's side of the field, certainly not what they wanted.
Put it mildly, that is so frustrating because that signifies there's a drive going on. You're in a good spot, great place to run some of your best offense. Instead, they turn the ball over.
Yeah, turn the ball over last time. See if they can avoid doing it here. Now a man open down the middle of the field. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. 23 yards the pick up there.
First and 10 at the 40.
Oh, that was a pretty route right there because it's all about finding a window on a route like that. He lined up on his left, ran the deep in route over the middle, and the ball was right where it needed to be. Really good trust between quarterback and receiver. Really good completion.
Another good gain. That's now 35 yards combined on those last two plays. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. And my goodness, another interception. Picked off at the 25. There he goes, right side. And he will bring it back. An interception return for a Colts TD. This D wanted to put it away before we even get to the fourth quarter, widening that margin a bit further.
And while they won't just empty the bench just yet, if you're a backup, start loosening up. I think you'll get a chance to play before this one is over now with that type of a cushion.
Extra point splits the uprights, and the lead will swell by one more. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And it'll come out to the 25 as he will not attempt to return.
25-yard line.
The Jacksonville offense set to begin their next drive. And following the pick six, and they have decent field position in throwing that pick six. We'll see how they attack. And now here is another interception. Picked up by Kenny Moore. And he's going to return it to...